While the most well-known Cold War-era military jet aircraft came from Britain, the United States, and the Soviet Union, Sweden quietly developed what would become the most advanced fighter jet in Europe at the time. The Saab 37 Viggen was a mighty machine, with a name that alluded to millennia-old Norse mythology, and it was easily recognizable, as it was the first canard design aircraft produced in quantity. The historic aircraft could fly steadily at speeds above Mach 2 at high altitudes and operate from short runways, ready to serve their home country at a moment's notice. And despite Sweden maintaining a strict policy of neutrality at the height of the Cold War, its pilots were willing to risk their lives to do the right thing if a nuclear conflict with Russia were to explode, with their Viggens more than ready for battle. On to the next big thing. In the early 1950s, Saab Aerospace Company developed the Drucken, an aerodynamically advanced fighter that made its maiden flight in 1955. After this achievement, the Swedish Air Force immediately began setting the requirements for its next generation of combat aircraft. Expected to fly no earlier than the mid-1960s, the new aircraft was planned to be adaptable for all tactical mission roles, with an integrated weapon system that would operate in conjunction with Sweden's National Electronic Air Defense System, STRIL 60. One radical requirement for the proposed aircraft was its ability to operate from short runways only 1,640 feet long as part of the BAS 60 airbase system. Introduced in the late 1950s and developed by the Swedish Air Force during the Cold War, BAS 60 revolved around the forced dispersal of many aircraft across several World War II airbases, including road runways acting as backups. Other requirements included having high maneuverability and low turbulence sensitivity at subsonic, low-level flight, Mach 2 performance at high altitude, and the ability to be easily repaired and serviced, even for personnel without much training. Enabling so many operations imposed plenty of critical demands on the design. As such, over 100 different concepts were examined in previous studies to develop the best possible aircraft with single and twin-engine configurations, traditional and double delta wings, and canard installment. Cold War happenings. In 1960, the United States National Security Council, led by President Dwight D. Eisenhower, presented Sweden with an irresistible proposition, the 37NX Military Technology Agreement, in which American officials promised military help in the event of a Soviet attack. As part of the agreement, Swedish engineers were allowed access to America's latest aeronautical technology, and the interactions made it more possible for Saab to design a faster and cheaper aircraft. Then, in December of 1961, the Swedish government approved the development of Aircraft System 37. Built at the height of the Cold War, when a potential Russian attack was a genuine concern, this was by far the largest industrial development task ever attempted in Sweden. By 1962, most of the project's elements were either finished or close to being fully developed, including the power plant, ejector seat, arms, reconnaissance systems, training equipment, and the fighter itself. A development contract was subsequently signed in the fall. The daunting venture accounted for 10% of all Swedish research and development funding throughout the decade. The Lightning Axe. The Saab 37 Viggen was a single-engine, short-medium-range combat aircraft with a highly advanced aerodynamic configuration for its time, a radical design featuring an aft-mounted double delta wing. In addition, the aircraft had small, high-set delta-shaped canard foreplanes, and the Saab model became the first mass-produced aircraft to ever feature them. The name Viggen had two distinct meanings. The first referred to Oxvik, which is historically translated to Thunderstones. In Norse mythology, an Oxvik is what the Viking Age inhabitants of Scandinavia called the prehistoric stone axes. Sent by the god Thor in lightning strikes, these axes were believed to have magical properties, like lightning protection. The second interpretation came from Vik, the Swedish word for tufted duck, in reference to its canard configuration, canard being the French word for duck. While Saab originally planned to power the Viggen with a single Rolls-Royce Medway engine, the aerospace company chose to license the Pratt & Whitney JT8D engine when its development was cancelled, and created a modified version of it, the Volvo RM8. To keep the landing distance short, The Saab 37's airframe included a thrust reverse to help slow the aircraft down. A one-of-a-kind creation in single-engined aircraft, the thrust reverse could be used to taxi backward, similar to a car. While backing up, however, the pilot needed to be careful not to use the wheel brake toe pedals, as the aircraft could easily tip over. Since the early design period, Saab engineers decided that the Viggen should replace the workload and performance of a second crew member with a digital central computer and a heads-up display. The computer, called Central Calculator 37, was the world's first airborne machine to use integrated circuits, supporting the pilot by performing functions such as navigation, flight control, and weapon aiming calculations. Swedish Duck. As originally planned, the first Saab 37 flew in 1967, with the company's chief test pilot Eric Dahlstrom at the controls. Dahlstrom described the new jet as easy to control. The Swedish government initially planned for 800 Viggens to replace all their other combat aircraft in service. However, a mix of inflation and several eventualities reduced the total to 329. The first Saab 37 Viggen was delivered to the Swedish Air Force in July of 1971. At the time of its introduction, the Viggen was the most advanced fighter jet in Europe. Conversation training for the new Viggen pilots included a minimum of 450 flight hours, including other models, the Viggen, and several simulators that were seen as a decisive factor in the ease of conversion to the type. By 1974, Sweden's newest fighters' safety and reliability levels were above expectations. And while the Saab 37 wouldn't see combat service, it would prove to be a safe, reliable, and easy-to-maintain aircraft. The finished product was an outstanding performer, capable of hitting 1,386 miles per hour, climbing at 40,000 feet per minute, and reaching a total service ceiling of 59,000 feet. For armament, the jet carried one 30mm Oerlikon KCA cannon with 125 rounds, and had three hardpoints under each wing, plus three under the fuselage. One of its only significant issues happened during low-level flight, in which birds constantly threatened the system. To counter this, the Swedish Air Force paid closer attention to their migratory patterns. By then, the Swedish Air Force had two operation squadrons working with the Viggen, with a third ready for training. In addition, there were multiple versions of the type. The two primary ones were the AJ-37 ground attack version, which could carry up to 15,500 pounds of weapons load on 9 hardpoints, and the late JA-37 all-weather interceptor version. Other variants served as strike fighters, aerial reconnaissance or maritime patrol aircraft, and a two-seat trainer. Nordic Angels. In the height of the Cold War, when East-West tensions were at their highest point, Viggen pilots flew approximately 500 live quick reaction alert, or QRA missions per year, to intercept any unidentified aircraft approaching Swedish airspace. These targets came from both Warsaw and NATO nations flying close to Swedish airspace over the Baltic Sea and near the Gulf of Bothnia. Still, the most challenging QRA targets were the United States Air Force's Lockheed SR-71 Blackbirds, with a reputation of being uncatchable and able to outrun missiles. The SR-71's impressive performance capabilities provided a unique opportunity for Viggen pilots to evaluate and experiment with several intercept solutions against high-speed, high-altitude threats. By the mid-1980s, the Swedish pilots managed to achieve radar lock-on with radar on the SR-71 numerous times by using the predictable patterns of the Blackbird's routine flights over the Baltic Sea. Soon after, in June of 1987, a Blackbird, flown by Lieutenant Colonels Dwayne Knoll and Tom Veltry, experienced a sudden engine failure during one such mission. While flying over the neutral waters of the Baltic Sea near Soviet territory, one of the jet's powerful Pratt & Whitney J-58-1 afterburning turbofan engines lost power. The crew had no choice but to descend to 25,000 feet over Swedish airspace, and the men were left in a vulnerable position. Suddenly, the Blackbird was intercepted by two pairs of Swedish Saab 37 Viggen fighter jets, which protected the spy plane and ensured that no enemy fighter would try to harass it. The four Swedish pilots proved to be guardian angels for the crew of the SR-71. At the time, the Soviet Air Force had a squadron of MiG-25 PD Foxbat high-speed interceptors based in East Germany, which were regularly sent to try and intercept the Baltic Express to no avail. Still, no details of the 1987 encounter between the SR-71 and the Saab 37 Viggens were published until 3 decades later. Recognition. In the 1990s, several major avionics upgrades were made to the aircraft, now designated as the JA-37D variant, including a more updated computer. By then, however, it was slowly being replaced by the newer Saab JAS-39 Gripen, with the last active model of the Saab 37 Viggen retired in November of 2005. Still, a few models were used for electronic warfare training against the Gripen, and their last official flights happened in 2007. 10 years later, in a ceremony in Stockholm on November 28, 2017, United States Air Force officials presented all Swedish pilots with air medals for their brave actions during the Cold War. Thank you for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, make sure to hit the like button and share it with someone who might like it. And for more exciting historical stories, follow this and all our Dark Documentaries channels. Stay tuned.